everyone, and welcome to another episode to Intro to World Creator 2 Extras. I'm Tyler, and in this video, I'm going to go over how I personally set up World Creator 2 for each of my projects, specifically the UI setup. The first thing I'm going to do is change my personal UI interface configuration, the color settings that I mentioned in the previous episode. To do that, we're going to go back up to the Options tab, Interface, and then I'm going to go under Skin Colors here. I'm going to select Load. And then I'm going to navigate to where I've got it saved at, and it's right here, TPXML. I'm going to select that and then open. And now you can see a lot of things have kind of changed here, but let's go ahead and go back to the Surface tab here so that we could really see some of the differences. All right, so here on the left that I'll put up, you'll see a comparison of what the original UI settings were. And on the right here is exactly how I like it. It's a little bit more minimalistic and it's pretty straightforward. There's not those bars that you can see here in the image on the left. And it's just a lot more clean for me to work. And this time, if I hover over stuff, I've got a little orange piece, as well as on the left where the quick toolbar is, if I hover over a blue icon, it turns orange. And that orange is the same orange that I've got selected here in the bottom right, where my multi-generation frame progress bar is located. So that's just one thing that I like to have set up. And if you want this UI set up, then go ahead and head on over to my Patreon page, link in the description, and I'll offer that up for free. You don't have to pay anything to get that UI. It's just something I like to give out to anyone who wants this clean and minimal setup. And the next thing I want to do, which is probably more custom to me that I like to see, is the way I want to view the viewport looks, basically. So specifically, I want to change what the skybox is and how the terrain shaders are being displayed. So to do that, we need to go up here to the trees, which is our scene tab. Select that, and then we're going to select Environment. So World Creator 2, first and foremost, is a landscape designer. The rendering and visual aspect to it is all secondary because the goal of the program is to basically create convincing terrains to the real world or however you want to design it, and everything else is secondary. So any of the rendering aspects to World Creator 2 don't get exported to something else. So with that, let's think of using the viewport as two modes. So there's the design mode and the realistic mode. This sky properties here that says realistic mode is the default, but I'm going to click this and then select none. So with none, it basically just turns off the skybox, and this becomes what I like to call, as I mentioned a second ago, design mode. It's the mode where you just focus on the design of the terrain and not so much the rendering of the viewport. After we've got that, the next thing I want to do is turn off any of the visual impedance. And by that, I mean anything that's going to add post-process of visual distractions to the work. And that is things such as the world and scatter here, turn that off, and the fog. These are great settings we will look at during the realistic half of the program, where we'll do a rendering within the application, but not during the design phase or the design mode. Next, after we've changed those settings, let's go ahead and pop on over to the render subtab here. Again, there are a few visual distractions I like to turn off for the design process. Let's just scroll down and let's turn off bloom. And also you can turn off sun flares. And as you can see, here's everything else that should automatically already be turned off. If it's not off, you can just copy these settings here. And then this is basically how I like to operate. So the last piece that I want to touch is the reflectance color of the terrain itself. And to look at that, it's right up here at the top under reflections properties. So we're going to change the reflectance of the terrain to what's called 18% gray, or in photography, it's referred to as the reflective values of the white balance levels in the scene. In layman's terms, when looking at the color values of a photo or a model, or even in graphics, it is best to see and source colors in a scene that has the correct white color balance values. To do this means the light in the scene needs to be in the middle between pure black and pure white. This value does not mean necessarily 50% gray, but instead it means 50% of the perceived lightness or illuminance to the human eye. Long story short, and with some math here and there, the value of 50% illuminance comes around to about 18-ish percent gray. And if we were to convert that to an RGB value, that comes out to be 777777. So to get that, we need to go under here where it says terrain base color, click this color bar, and that's going to allow us to change the terrain reflectance value to any number color. But since we want a 50% illuminance value, and to get that 18% RGB of 777777, we just need to change this number here to all sevens. And now the terrain reflectance color has changed to the appropriate white color balance that I want. And also, I want to do the exact same thing for our background color here. Since we removed the skybox, World Creator has defaulted to this flat gray. Let's go back to our environment subtab here. And then under the sky properties, we have another color bar. So let's just go ahead and select that. And then let's put in that same value since it's that 18% gray. And now we've got the correct white color balance of a pure mid-gray that we need to view colors accurately once we get into the texturing process of our terrain. And ever so often, it's nice to have the background color here just a lot darker than this, just for that perceived contrast between work plane and terrain plane. So all these RGB values, if you just change them to something like 0.2, 0.2 and 0.2, we get a really nice dark background that really makes that terrain pop if you just want to focus on your terrain. One reason why we set this to all sevens is that it's our perceived notion of illuminance with the human eye that we can graphically see the colors of the textures correctly. But when you're doing things like the terrain effects, like filters, or if you're shaping the terrain, yeah, I think it's nice to have this really dark background because you can see the detail just pop in the terrain. In a nutshell, this is the way that I like to set up my new projects. User interface wise, I'll keep the default UI that comes with World Creator for the main series and the other videos. But henceforth, for the extra videos like this one, I'll use my personal UI so that you can kind of get a sense between both versions, and that way we have a consistent flow throughout this series. And to reiterate, if you would like to use my UI, don't forget to head on over to my Patreon linked in the description where you can get the UI for free. So, thank you all for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.